Karma here. Welcome to my channel and welcome to this hair. My hair story goes back years, you guys, but I do not have time to put it all in one video. But I will try and upload another video where I talk about it. The other video that I will address is how I had relaxed hair and I got growth with relaxed hair, and my hair was healthy with relaxed hair, and then I started to treat it bad. After I gained so much health and length, I started to get comfortable. So that's a completely different story, and it's possible to get length with relaxed hair. So don't let nobody tell you that it isn't, because it is possible and I have pictures to prove it. But anywho, fast forward to now. After I was taking care of my hair and I got it healthy, I began to neglect it again, and now I'm back where I was years ago. A little different, a lot different, but I'm back to where I was. Now a little bit about my hair. My hair has been, I haven't had a relaxer in about 2 to 3 months now. And since I got that relaxer, I have not I have not flat ironed or applied a whole bunch of heat to my hair. I did apply heat in the front here. You know what I mean? I applied heat. But other than that, the rest of my hair I never applied heat to. And as a matter of fact, I couldn't even tell you the last time when I flat ironed my entire hair. I really don't put a whole bunch of heat on it. Now, when I did a relaxer, not this last relaxer I did a few months ago, but maybe one relaxer before that, I got a chemical burn on my scalp. And what had happened was, I guess I left it in too long, or it was just too strong for my hair or my scalp, and it gave me chemical burns. So fast forward to now, my chemical burns have not healed all the way, and that's mainly because I kept bothering it and I kept irritating it and making it inflamed. So I decided to, okay, I need to leave them alone. Please forgive the way I look, by the way. I am gonna go to bed. Actually, I'm gonna fix my hair again and then go to bed. But anywho, so on top of that, I was getting my hair braided. I started wearing wigs more, and it was between the hair braiding and the wigs. My edges, or at least the ends, started to experience breakage. Now, never in my entire life, and it's just here and here. Never in my entire life have I had this happen. Never. And I never thought I'd be a victim to broken edges. And it's no bald spot. It's no, you know, none of them are, you know, no bald spots. It's just the breakage due to the braids, they were too tight. And the wigs. Probably more the wigs than the braiding, if anything. Because it just pulled at my hair and it just kept pulling, and finally it just gave way. So, I have shorter sides just here and here, and I think maybe a little in the back. Yeah, maybe a little in the back, not a whole lot. But yeah, so it was shorter in the back. Now, maybe 2 months ago, so after I got the relaxer, I cut my hair off about good 2 to 3 inches. And what I did was I just came, went to the restroom, got my scissors, put my hair in a ponytail, and cut what was bothering me. And I let it down, and this is pretty much how it ended up. It was a little shorter than this, actually, but because that was about 2 months ago. So I still have a lot of relaxed hair on my head. But every month I do want to cut off. You know, because I'm transitioning. So I do want to cut off my relaxed hair over time. And hopefully by December, it will all be gone. And I hope to cut it off. Now, since maybe 2-3 months ago, this is how much new growth, sorry, that I have obtained since then. So let me see if I can bring it in a bit. Ooh. Hold on. So I've probably, yeah, this is a good one. I've probably obtained about, I'm trying to look at my phone and hold this, about that much new growth. So this is all pretty much damaged or relaxed hair. You can see it a lot better like that. So yeah, that is about 2 to 3 months of growth right there. Now my hair is very thick. It's extremely thick. My mother got it from her side of the family. My mother's hair is really thick. She actually is a natural right now. She cut her hair, I think it was a year ago, and now she's natural. My sister's natural now. She probably cut her hair a few months back. And so for me, it was like, all right, I think I'm just gonna do it because I'm tired of this. I'm tired of the breakage. I'm tired of having to keep up with relaxers. I'm tired of having to, even though I have it straight, it's not, I really only have one way I can do it, because if I'm going to curl it again, a lot of times I apply heat to it, and I really don't, you know, I don't have patience for all that. So, I don't have patience for damaged hair, and to make it look good, and still have it damaged. Now, I did say that I did get health with my hair in the past, so I will have to do a separate video on that. But I did. But now, I think I'm just ready. I'm ready to transition and I'm ready to move on from this relaxed hairstyle, lifestyle, I should say. But this is my hair. I haven't dyed it in over a year and a half. So, I mean, if there is anything left, it might be at the very, very end, but I doubt it. If anything, this might be my natural hair color here, because I haven't dyed my hair forever, and my hair color is kind of a light reddish brown, dark reddish brown, I don't know. There's some red tints in it. Sorry. So yeah, join me on my transitioning, and if you are transitioning, please transition with me, because this is going to be an experience. I'm learning as I go. I will go over how I'm treating or how I treat my chemical burns. I'll make a separate video on that because it was bad and now it's a lot better. A whole lot better, I think. So I'll tell you how long I've been doing it and all that stuff. So please be patient. Please don't judge me. This is my hair. This is what it is right now. It's a hot mess. I'm gonna actually put it up. The inside of my hair is very kinky and I'm trying not to manipulate it. I have no issue with flat ironing, but it's not for me anymore. And that's going into my old story, but I don't flat iron, and I think this entire year I can probably count how many times I've actually flat ironed my entire head on one hand. And it's probably just maybe twice or once. I can't even tell you one time that I flat ironed my hair on the cool this year. But yeah, so this is it. Please join me. Join me for the ride. This is the length of my hair. Now, mind you, I did cut it, and it's terrible cut. Like, I literally just got scissors and cut it. And actually, I think I have flat ironed it once. And it kind of looked cute when I flat ironed it. But this is it. And before it was like right here, I want to say. And I just cut it. It was worse before. Like, the ends were bad. They were just chewed up and like, ugh. And these ends are bad too. But before, they were really bad. That's why I just stared in the mirror one day and was like, cut it off. All right, so stay tuned. I will be giving updates and doing more videos. And thank you for being a part of my journey. I need all the support I could get. Bye. Talk to you guys later.